Audi's marketing team certainly didn't stretch their imaginations too hard when it came time to name the all-new e-tron. Because not only does e-tron refer to their lineup of high-performance electrified luxury vehicles, but also refers to this specific model. It seems a bit silly to me, but oh well, because what's not silly is the capability coming out of this all-electric SUV. Compared to some other electrified vehicles, the e-tron doesn't announce its green intentions quite as loudly. In fact, at a quick glance, you could easily confuse this for being the latest Q5 SUV from the brand. And that boils down to design elements like this conventional Audi grille, which is something you're seeing less and less of as more EVs phase this design element out, which will certainly appeal to some Audi buyers. This e-tron SUV is certainly a handsome looking rig, no doubt helped by this Navara blue metallic paint, which pops quite nicely against these optional 21-inch black wheels, which behind them sport dynamic orange massive brake calipers. I also like the integration of that same dynamic orange color in this e-tron badging here on the fender, right over the charging port. Our fully loaded Kronos trim tester also swaps out the standard polished trim for this blacked out stuff that I quite like. It also matches the blacked out badging here on the trunk. And I like the family tie into other Audi models like the Q8 with this large LED taillight strip right here. The e-tron sports a 95 kilowatt hour battery pack, and as you might expect from an Audi vehicle, dual motor all-wheel drive is standard. Out of the box, this thing produces 402 horsepower and 490 pound-feet of torque when in the optional sport mode. Though, if that's not enough for you, an optional e-tron S upgrade adds a third motor into this thing, boosting power to 496 horsepower and a whopping 718 pound-feet of torque. The standard e-tron will return a claimed range of 226 miles. That high-performance e-tron S sees range drop slightly down to just 208. Either way, this thing supports up to 150 kilowatt fast charging, which means this thing can charge up quite quickly indeed. Though on the flip side, at your home, Audi does supply as standard a power supply that supports a regular wall outlet or optionally a converter to support 220 volt charging. Audi is positioning e-tron as a lineup of high-end luxury vehicles, so it comes as no surprise that the interior fit and finish of this new e-tron SUV is up to par with high-end Audi vehicles. There's a lovely blend of colors, textures, and materials happening in here. Things feel very soft and supple to the touch, which is quite nice. One design element I like in particular is actually the shifter for the automatic transmission, which from the driver's perspective almost appears to be floating right here on this natural palm rest. But Audi's real claim to fame as of late has been their technology suite, and e-tron is no exception with the latest version of their MMI infotainment display here. With a 10-inch top screen and a 9-inch bottom screen, this display and interface is gorgeous. It uses a mix of its sort of haptic feedback touchscreen and physical knobs and buttons down here for all the controls, and is really just quite nice to use once you get used to all the things it can in fact do. MMI also supports wireless Apple CarPlay and wireless Android Auto connectivity as well, which is quite nice to have. But one of my favorite Audi features, and one present in the new e-tron, is actually this Virtual Cockpit Plus driver display system. This is the latest version of this interface, and it's just a real joy to use and toggle through all the options. That includes, among other things, a real-time traffic map that has a really nice view of your surroundings. Of course, it doesn't end there because we naturally have a Bang & Olufsen premium audio system. These power seats are both heated and ventilated, and we have this large panoramic sunroof. Sitting here in the back seat of e-tron, I'm happy to report that at 6'1", I can sit behind myself quite comfortably with just about an inch or so of knee room, but a few inches of headroom, which is pretty good overall. The real nice thing, as you might expect from a luxury SUV, are, well, the luxuries. Not only do we have sunshades back here, which are a nice touch, we have our own climate control down here that also includes heated seats. There are also two USB-C fast chargers down here along with a 12 volt outlet. The e-tron earns major brownie points when it comes to storage because this thing has 29 cubic feet of trunk space, and as you can see, it's quite a deep space in here indeed, more than enough for the Costco run. If you need more storage, of course, you can drop the second row seats down flat, which doubles the amount of space you have on tap. But if you need even more than that, this false floor lifts up and reveals extra storage down here, along with the cargo net. The e-tron sports some pretty hardcore hardware as standard, at least as far as driving dynamics are concerned. This thing has an adjustable air suspension that's continuously adjusting for imperfections in the road, as well as offering different ride heights based on the drive mode you're in. There are also some absolutely enormous 6-piston caliper brakes up front, which look great behind those 21s. And as you might expect from a high-end Audi on adaptive air suspension, this thing rides beautifully. It is really uncanny how, despite those big wheels, this thing is truly just, it glides down the road. It's fantastic in that way. And as you might expect from an electrified powertrain, the response is immediate. So when you combine that, you get this really effortless driving experience, which is just great. It also helps that thanks to that instantaneous power delivery, this thing can still tow up to 4,000 pounds, which is pretty impressive for a family hauler. I mentioned previously that the exterior styling doesn't scream EV, and I think the drive from behind the wheel is in a similar vein. Sure, there's no engine noise, just the hum of electric motors doing their thing, but from behind the wheel, this does have that sort of solid Audi feel we've come to expect from the brand. My only real nitpick about the driving experience is the fact that despite being an EV, the e-tron does not support one-pedal driving. On other electrified vehicles, when you lift off the accelerator, the car comes to a slow and then a stop quite naturally, and funnels that kinetic energy that's normally wasted in braking right back into the battery pack, giving you a few more miles of range per charge. Fortunately, however, that is a software tweak rather than a hardware tweak, and it's something Audi could theoretically implement in an over-the-air update if they choose to do so. With its $71,995 base price, this does compare favorably at first glance against luxury rivals like the Jaguar I-Pace and indeed the Tesla Model Y. Though the number crunchers out there may have caught on to the fact that the e-tron's range does trail some of the competition at least a bit. For those who think range is king, well, the Tesla will still be at the top of the crop for you. A Model Y will crack well over 300 miles on a single charge by comparison. If the base MSRP seems like a pricey proposition to you, then the as-tested price of this thing of over $86,000 will surely give you a heart attack. But that's just the name of the game in this ultra-luxury EV SUV segment. That's more or less the base price, for example, of the new BMW iX. On the flip side, by comparison, the dark horse in this competition appears to be the new Cadillac Lyriq, which undercuts the base price of this thing by around 9 grand and offers up to 312 miles of range, which sounds to me like the truest Tesla competitor of all to date. While this e-tron may not have the most solid range compared to its competition, it does offer a really solid drive. And it does espouse all the hallmark values that buyers have come to expect from modern Audi products. If you couldn't tell by the amount of name dropping I've been doing, this is a very competitive segment to be in. Still, if you're a brand fan, the new e-tron does feel like a great offering from Audi. And a really solid alternative to maybe a gasoline-powered Q5 you could have been considering instead. If you want to learn more about the new Audi e-tron or some of the other vehicles I've mentioned throughout this review, you can do so by clicking the link in the description down below.